Huntington Beach is known as Surf City. It's pretty much been a surf culture kind of town since back in the oil days. Formed here in 1955, the first surf club. The year after that, the first surf shop opened, and in 1959, what we know today as the US Open of Surfing started. So, you know, you've had over 50 years of competition that's been covered all over the world. And now we're going to set the record for the world's biggest surfboard, and we're going to set the record with the most surfers on one wave on a board. I'm Peter P.T. Townend, old surfing champ, world champion in 1976, and have resided in Surf City now for 37 years. There's a place in New England that cut the foam for us, and then we shipped that across country. Put it in a boat building place called Westerly Marine is where the lamination has taken place, and we'll drive it down PCH and try and set the record.
My sailing career took me to a lot of really interesting places. I got a chance to live in Europe and Australia and New Zealand, and so I opened up a service shop in the south of France, one in South Africa, one in New Zealand, and one here in Rhode Island. My name's JB, John Barnett, and I'm the owner and president of Moldcam here in Bristol, Rhode Island. And we're a five-axis CNC tooling shop. When I told the guys that we were going to carve the world's largest surfboard, they got really excited about it. We carve all kinds of different shapes. We've done race cars, we've done submarines, some drone parts, rocket parts, sailboats and powerboats and rowing shells. We rarely ever do the same thing twice. Mostly what we do is prototyping new innovative designs that are going to be built in composites. In a lot of ways, we look at ourselves as digital fabricators. The development in composites over the past 20 years has largely been in computer-aided design. In that process, you need to take time to stop and realize the human component and the craftsmanship that's required is equally as important as this high-tech digital world that we live in.
You need someone to guide it along and to interact with the computer. It really is cutting edge to make these products out of safer materials for people to work with. It's done very efficiently. Everything's recycled. I'm Bob Steele. I'm the project manager. Doing the work that would have been done in probably 200 man hours, what that machine did in just under 4.5 hours. It's really the future of technology.
Real combination of old school craftsmanship meets cutting edge technology.
I started surfing in 1960. The first place I ever surfed was Huntington Cliffs in Huntington Beach. Actually built my very first surfboard. That's when I became interested in building things out of fiberglass and composite. And was around the water, and it was a natural progression to go from surfing to being involved with boats. My name's Lynn Bowser, and I'm the president of Westerly Marine. I worked for a couple of different companies before I met my business partner, Steve Lee, and we decided to go out on our own. We started Westerly in 1970. We build high-end racing sailboats and cruising sailboats. We're always developing our technology. We have five ovens on the site, one of them being 75 feet long, where we're building the big board. I think early on, they realized that wanting to build this giant surfboard was not going to fit with any of the local surf shops, where a small shortboard, one guy can just pick up and flip over in a few moments. This was a big affair of taking it out under a hoist and putting it under straps and take several people just to roll it over to glass the other side. Bob realized that early on and decided, hey, we need to take this to a boat builder. And of course, we were stoked to build the world's largest surfboard. He's a surfer, we're surfers, and it was a natural fit. But we wanted to reach out to the surf industry. I knew that we were going to need someone who was well-versed and experienced in the unique techniques of building a surfboard. Our guys are very capable of laminating, but they don't know all of the little tricks and the nuances that a guy like Kai knows from building boards all his life.
I've always been able to just figure things out. You know, obviously a lot of guys get mentored down through, you know, top shapers. And I never went through that. I kind of just grabbed a blank and started going for it. I still have the template and it's pretty janky. I'm Kyron Stewart from Newport Beach, California, and I shape surfboards. Biggest board I ever built was an 18-foot stand-up paddle board. Well, now 42-foot board, but it's a version of Brett Simpson's board. With CNC boards, it's a little bit harder to actually get just that perfect curved surface. So you have to finish the board by hand because the computer can't hit those certain spots that you'll see with your eye or you can do with your hands. It's different than making surfboards and it's different than making boats.
The technology has been used to shape the board on CNC machine, 3D, and then it's really high tech. I'm Frédéric Couroux, I'm French. I'm doing the structural analysis to make the board stiff, light, and strong. Surfing has always been passionate people, ideas, and they do on their own. You don't need a computer to design a good surfboard. But what's interesting is there's a brilliant guy we work with. He's really a pro surfer, and then he gives all the insights from his knowledge. We're discussing, for example, to place the fins. Otherwise, yeah, to make a platform to go down and straight and designed by computers, you will be super stiff and super light. Yeah, it could be done, but there's this, I don't think you would have all this passion around, that's for sure.
So several years ago, a bunch of us sitting around, we were talking about, wouldn't it be great to try and break the world record, build the largest surfboard and have the most number of people on the board. And out of that whole, you know, a bunch of people sitting around, we said, well, let's go for it. This massive 42 foot by about 12 foot by 16 inch, 1,100 pound, will be setting two world records, south side of the pier on June 20th, Saturday, 2015. My name is Kelly Miller. I'm the president and CEO of Visit Huntington Beach here in Surf City, USA.
The original board that set the record, Nev built, as everybody knows, and we wouldn't have been able to build the one that we built and actually make it better than that one without Nev's original CAD drawings.
I cannot believe the logistical effort that's gone into this and the professionalism that's gone into putting this together. And to be here is just like, I'm in a dream.
So we've already set one world record. We have the world's biggest surfboard. Now we got to catch a wave for 10 seconds, okay? And this man here is the judge of that. So let's go do this record, right? Let's do this.
So the mark to be for most people riding a surfboard is 47. So what I'm looking for today is more than 47 people who are standing on the surfboard for 10 seconds riding a wave. They're able to do that, it'll be a new Guinness World Records title.
There's the number, 66. Right there, 66.
Awesome, good luck.
My name is Mike Baumberger. I'm the Marine Safety Division Chief for the city of Huntington Beach. We're taking an 1,100-pound vessel, and we're gonna tow it into the surf line. Into that very environment where it's everything against what we have been trained to do. My role is to make sure it's done as safely as possible.
Hey, you guys, it's not only history on the beach, but it's history in heaven. I think God is proud of us today. So, yeah, so let's pray. Jesus, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your creation called the waves, and we honor you, our creator. We ask God today as we go out that you would, first of all, keep us safe and that we could accomplish it in one wave, God. We thank you for the city of Huntington Beach, Surf City, our home, and we bless you this day. In Jesus' name, amen.
We got the 60-some people on the board. We have the jet skis going. We got the green light from Marine Safety. This pier will be packed, the beach will be packed, and the people cheering, which is pretty cool.
They might catch this one. They got the power to do it. Here comes the swell. All right, this is it. They're having a go. One, two, three, four. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Beautiful, beautiful dismount.
It feels more than awesome, and it feels special. It feels special to be a part of the community we live in.
Can you wake up in the morning and be like, I'm gonna go surf a 42-foot long surfboard with Aaron Chang and Lakey and just so many people I admire.
I don't know what I was doing 10 years ago, but this is so much bigger and so much better, and I'm so proud to be with this guy who's a legend and all these other legends here. It's unbelievable.
Pretty spectacular. Like, I was on the front and I looked back, and exactly like you said, there's so many people that have contributed to this sport, made this sport what it is, you know, and himself creating these boards, and it's a special honor to be a part of it.
We did it! Yes! Guinness World Book of Records!
Congratulations! I'd like to welcome you to the Guinness World Records family and present that certificate.
That's super awesome! This is the best ever. That's a world record right there, Huntington Beach.
So we celebrated 100 years of surfing last year. So this is like, okay, so what's the next century gonna be like? It's just not about, you know, the people setting the record, but I think it's a celebration of Surf City USA, setting that first cornerstone in that foundation for the next 100 years of surfing. Well, here's the starting point. A board like this setting two world records, everybody can celebrate in that.